I mean, one way that happens, of course, is a certain elitism, feeling like, okay, I'm good at math, and therefore I'm going to lord it over other people, or I'm going to think of math as, I mean, we do this in unconsciously, right? We say, oh, you're so good at math, I was never that good at math, right? Or something like that. And that's something I hear all the time, right? And, you know, in some ways I joke that like being a mathematician is almost like being a priest, because, you know, when people find out what you do, they feel the need to confess, right? It's like confessing math sins. And part of that is I buy into it as well when I accept that kind of praise, right? Like it makes me feel good. And so there's that, there's elitism. But, you know, there are other things that we do that I think are really harmful, right? We start thinking about math as one-dimensional, like it's only about being fast, when in fact, for professional mathematicians, it's not about being fast at all, right? It's about thinking about ideas deeply and slowly, in fact. But, you know, we measure people by their performance in some ways, in some axis, the number of papers, you know, for professional mathematicians, the number of papers you've written, right? And that's really harmful. It's detrimental. And I would love people to see math as much more multidimensional, right? It's growth in virtues. It's growth in creativity. It's growth in persistence. It's growth in a disposition to beautiful things. And, you know, when employers are looking for people to hire, they're hiring math majors not for specific skills like factoring polynomials. I mean, they're hiring people because they're going to be persistent in problem solving. They're going to look at a problem from many different angles. And those are all virtues. And so that's sort of the piece that I wish people would see. And in some ways that would help change the profession, make it more inclusive.